The International Monetary Fund calls on policymakers to continue spending money to shore up the global economy. The IMF says without aid and additional financing, poor countries would be left behind as more developed nations recover from the pandemic. The multilateral lender also warns while the global economic outlook has significantly improved, more needs to be done given the high uncertainty brought by the pandemic.
Once policy support is withdrawn, we would see companies that have been pretty much on life support falling off the cliff, and SMEs are likely to be more severely impacted, meaning that one in 10 jobs may disappear. So the question is, what should policymakers do? First, it is critical when we would withdraw support to at the same time lift it up to help people reskill and reprofile, move from shrinking sectors to those that are expanding. We are going to have a different economy. It doesn't mean a worse economy if we think well in advance.
The IMF recently upgraded its global growth forecast for the year to 6% after a 3.3% contraction in 2020. On to the financial markets, U.S. stocks off to a strong start this quarter with the broad stock market index rising by a whopping 3.1%. The S&P 500 also hitting yet another record high overnight, boosted by a strong rally in major tech stocks as the bond market calmed. The S&P 500 managing to add 0.4% to close at 4097, while the tech-heavy Nasdaq climbed 1% as shares of Apple, Netflix, and Amazon rallied, and the Dow added 57 points. Meanwhile, the benchmark 10-year U.S. Treasury note fell to 1.62%. That is the lowest level since March 26 of this year, as the Fed reiterated it will continue with its easy monetary policies until the rebound is more secure. But trading activity has tapered off, with the four lowest volume days of the year happening this week ahead of first quarter earnings season next week, with results from big U.S. banks on tap.
I think it's interesting when you look at technology doing better, what's really done better is the short duration technology trades. So it's the stocks that you can measure by a multiple of earnings versus those stocks that you had to use a multiple of revenues as a yardstick for. So I think we threw all of technology out, like the baby with the bathwater, in the first quarter and that rotation. And as interest rates started inching up, and then we realized, wait a second, Google, Microsoft, Facebook, Apple, Amazon all have earnings in the here and now and actually can be measured on a multiple of price to earnings. So I think that has gotten investors back into those names necessarily.
On the data front, weekly initial jobless claims data show a second straight rise, conflicting with a recent payrolls report. A total of 744,000 Americans filed for unemployment benefits last week.
I think as we think about the employment situation, it's going to be uneven and improve. But I would pay much closer attention to the monthly non-farm payroll numbers and how many jobs this economy is creating. And know that while we had a blowout number at 960 for last month, we need that kind of number for the rest of this year to get anywhere close to getting back to where we were before the pandemic. It's going to be a gradual process.
Taking a look now at U.S. stock futures, all of the major indices are in the green, pointing to a higher open when trading resumes tonight, Manila time. Now, over here in Asia, stocks trading mixed this morning following that overnight rally on Wall Street after Powell's assurance the central bank can reinvigorate the U.S. economy without stoking painful inflation. Japan's Nikkei 225, as you can see, jumping around 1%. On the other hand, markets in South Korea and Australia in the red in early Friday morning trade.